Hello everyone, welcome back to another TF2 gameplay commentary. I just made a Pokemon gameplay commentary, but I thought I didn't really talk enough about stuff that's just happening in my life. I kinda just talked about the game, like not of it. By the way, Pokemon MMO, definitely check it out. It's pretty fun. Don't play too much or you'll get burnt out or something else. But I thought I could just say that. But yeah. This video is gonna be more like just me talking about less sort of game. More just kind of chilling. So I'm playing first of all, just a very basic jumping around. I forgot what this is called. Sticky jumper and grenade launcher and him, of course. Got that med pick. Anyway, I think I'm talking too much about the game already. Ooh, he got me. Okay. Now I have time to talk about stuff. So today, I went to this dinner. It's called High Honor Dinners. Basically, it's like students with like GPAs really high just like go to this dinner where teachers, which they nominate. They discuss, you know, what's so great about this student, stuff like that. Overall, okay event. Food was okay. Not the best, though. Can't complain too much since it is at school after all. What? Okay. Now, the food was kind of mid. But, other than that, I kind of enjoyed listening to some of the teachers joke around with the students. There was one social studies teacher who was pretty funny because he actually had a lot to reference. Like, the main kind of joke was how hard he beat the chem teacher's class at kickball because they, after the AP test, their classes went against each other to decide who's the best kickball champion in the school. And it turns out that loss, 5-7 in kickball, was really the target of a lot of banter that day, or today. I think it's pretty funny though, because each time he said it differently. The last time he was like, we soundly defeated Mr. M's class. And then in another case, he was like, we absolutely demolished Mr. M's class. That small change each time, I think, is pretty important for the effect of that to take place. So, yeah, that teacher was pretty funny. I wish I could have had him, but, you know, I don't really want to take AP level social studies classes because it's not my thing. It's just not what I enjoy. I mean, I don't really know if I would enjoy it. I just think I wouldn't, based on my previous experience in social studies. Okay, finally. Oh, I got him. Yeah, but the teacher I would have chosen. So I chose my chem teacher from last year. I also TA in physics for all of his classes, and he made a pretty funny speech about that, where he mentioned that four of his physics students were having fun, and they all realized that I was in their classes. I was in every single one of their classes. And so that was pretty funny. I mostly just talked to like a few students in each class, so I don't really know everyone, but that's just because I only started TAing physics in senior year, second semester, when my stuff got through the That did not just happen again. Okay. Yeah. I would say like the teacher I would have chosen if he were actually interested in this kind of thing would be, you know, Demo. So Demo is my CS teacher. He also taught me physics last year. I don't think I should have taken that class because it was kind of way too easy, but yeah, I probably should have jumped straight to AP. Although in that case I wouldn't have been able to get Dr. Morgan as a teacher. Oh, I just had to learn. Whatever, it's tough. It's fine. He's not even shooting me. Okay. Yeah, but I would have chosen him, you know, speaker, because I've just been in more of his classes, like probably like about 8, about 7, something like that. But I think he just doesn't believe in the whole thing where it's like high GPA and dinner board type deal. I kind of agree with him. I mean, I get what he's coming from. It's still, I don't really know exactly what his problem is because he didn't explain it in detail. Like, he didn't really justify it. He just kind of said he's not interested. But I get the sense it's something to do with the whole obsession with GPA, which I definitely agree with is a bad thing. Of course, he doesn't have anything against me. It's just the sort of issue of the system. And perpetuating that sort of mentality with this ion energy. Ooh, Epic is cool too. Ooh, crits. Okay. Anyway. Yeah. High honor dinner. I think it's relatively harmless in the scope of like what makes school such a GPA obsessed place, especially in this town, which is very obsessed with going into a big college. Of course, like many other places. He's not dead. After watching the talents. Yeah. So I mean, I don't think it's the main factor contributing to this sort of mentality across nation and the world, but it is one of the outputs of it, I would say. And most people don't actually even know about this whole thing, so the effect it has is probably relatively small. And there are a certain group of people who are really obsessed with college, like the students I'm talking about, who do actually know about this, and they're kind of obsessed with it. But most people don't actually care at all, which is, I think, what people should be like. I mean, would it be better if students actually cared about school? Probably. However, it's not... Well, even if that were true, like, every single person cared a lot about school, it might end up being situation in like California where everything is just becoming more and more competitive, and that just might actually be negative instead of doing good, because it might be like the point of negative marketing. Jump out. Yeah, there's a good balancing point where it's like too much obsession, where it's causing stress, and you know, the perfect amount where everyone's sort of competitive, but still willing to help each other out, where people don't become really snaky, And I would argue that in much of the country, things have become that negative, snaky like, situation where people are going against each other, actually like obstructing each other. This game's sort of going downhill from it. It's not too regular sticky bomb loadouts. Oh wait, I lost the numpad. I don't have a numpad anymore, so I can't really. Actually, I mean, I can't switch loadout. I guess I'll switch class with comma and then like a num. Yeah, so I would say I'm not sure why he doesn't want to do it, but that would be my guess. It's just perpetuating a system that's stressing students out, not really leading to real learning, or just like an obsession with grades. That's unproductive. Because there's kind of two ways to approach things. You can go for like memorization, just try to memorize every single fact, or you can try to learn concepts. And in real learning, I think people want to learn concepts. And in a grade-obsessed world, people might not care enough about the whole process of learning concepts and such to actually achieve what a good teacher aims for. Well, you know, the teacher I got, my AP Chem teacher, he's very supportive of this event. He's done many speeches, and he's more, I guess you could call him, like, traditional about school, or, like, his teaching philosophy, because he thinks tests are one of the best ways to gauge how much a student understands, and I actually kind of 70% agree with him. Because, you know, in a group project, you don't know who did what. And so if you just grade everyone as a whole, there could be some unfairness to it. Because, you know, the person who does the most work doesn't really want to be there because everyone else is just dead weight. And then students who didn't work hard at all, generally, they still get the same grade as the student who worked a lot. Their effects. And they probably might not have even contributed their own thinking. And giving a grade to that sort of brainless participation is also pointless and counterproductive. Oh! That's Andrew's hard to deal with. Do we have a blue one? Okay. As I was saying, the DJ I got to speak, he's more, you know, tests are very good, whereas the DJ who doesn't want to come, he thinks, well, he actually kind of still does tests, but more so, I guess that's not directly what he believes in, it's just like he happens to do tests as well, in addition to. Let's see. Yeah, but which one is actually right? I would have to say it's a mix of both. Because Demo, he does a lot of like jokes in class, and I think part of that is because when you tell jokes in addition to just doing the work, you could call it just teaching the material, what you do is you provide students some time to become interested in the actual class, where like they subconsciously associate the teaching the material with funny jokes. I think that's part of his idea, because it also gives like the brain a chance to rest after absorbing so much, and that's his way of doing things. Now, the teacher I got to speak, he still, you know, is funny, he tells stories, but I would say less so. I would say this teacher's main trait is that he uses a lot of analogies to teach concepts. That way it's easier to remember. Whereas Demo is more about just telling stories and then teaching the stuff, the material, in a more traditional sense. I think it's a fake spine. Let's see, what else can I talk about? All the students went up for a speech after their respective teacher gave the speech about the student. My speech was pretty solid. I would say it was like the most... I would say like creative one? Out of all the student speeches. I'm sweating right now. I'm not sweating. Try hard. Not the actual sweating. That would be so concerning. Everything above your neck. I'm missing the thing. Oh no, there's a sentry in there. No one ever killed the Genji on the road. Mission ends in 10 seconds. Scout's gonna be useless, but I don't think I can think of that I can get there personally. You failed! Oh, you got me. guys for watching, and see you guys next time.